King Mayadunne, the founder of Seethawaka, passed away in the year 1580. He was succeeded by his son, the brave, capable and ruthless Tikiri Bandara, also known as King Rajasinghe I. Tikiri Bandara inherited a Seethawaka whose star was rising fast, with almost the entirety of the old Kotte and Raigama kingdoms under its control. Following the Seethawakan triumph at Mulleriyawa in 1559, the much weakened Portuguese withdrew to the Colombo Fort with their puppet king of Kotte, Dharmapala, leaving the city of Kotte itself to the Seethawakans. In 1580, the Portuguese forced Dharmapala to transfer all rights of rule over Kotte kingdom to themselves, officially ending Kotte as a Sinhalese kingdom and instead making what little remained of it a Portuguese conquest. However, as their control was limited to the Colombo Fort and the lands immediately surrounding it, they represented no serious threat to Seethawaka, and as such, apart from a siege of the fort in 1580, were ignored by Tikiri Bandara. Though Seethawaka dominated the west of the island of Ceylon, its central hills were occupied by another powerful kingdom, that of Kandy. The old king, Jayavira Bandara, who had had a hand in bringing about fateful Vijayaba Kolle, was dead by 1581, with the kingdom instead being ruled by his son, Karaliyadde Bandara. Karaliyadde Bandara, however, had a minister named Veerasundara Bandara who wanted more power for himself. To get it, he contacted Tikiri Bandara in Seethawaka to propose that the latter invade Kandy. Tikiri Bandara accepted, seeing in this invitation an opportunity to expand his already considerable realm even further. In the year of 1582, Seethawakan armies invaded Kandy, defeating Karaliyadde's armies and marching to the gates of its capital, which they seized with the aid of Veerasundara Bandara, who betrayed Karaliyadde alongside his own forces. With his armies destroyed and his kingdom conquered, Karaliyadde Bandara fled to the Portuguese-controlled manor on the northwest coast of Ceylon. Though he was welcomed warmly by the Europeans there, he would never return to Kandy, dying in manor not long afterwards. Tikiri Bandara and Veerasundara Bandara spent the next few years consolidating their power in the Kingdom of Kandy. Finally, Tikiri Bandara departed the kingdom in 1587, leaving Veerasundara Bandara to rule Kandy in his absence. The King of Seethawaka then proceeded to travel to the western coast and besiege the Colombo Fort for the fourth time in 30 years. On this occasion, he even diverted all waterways near the fort in a futile attempt to cut off the fort's supply of fresh water. The Portuguese had not suffered seriously from food shortages in previous sieges due to their naval superiority, but at this period most of the Portuguese fleet in Ceylon happened to be away. The Europeans eventually ran out of supplies and began to starve. Towards the end of the siege, they were even forced to kill and eat cats and rats that resided within the fort. Their miserable situation was only exacerbated by the furious assaults mounted by the Seethawakans, which, though unsuccessful, forced the defenders onto the back foot. As the year of 1588 arrived, it seemed only a matter of time before the fort capitulated. Unfortunately, a large Portuguese fleet arrived in mid-1588 to resupply and reinforce the Colombo Fort, and all Tikiri Bandara had accomplished in the past year was undone. Realizing that the fort could now hold out indefinitely with supplies from the sea, he subsequently abandoned the siege of the Colombo Fort and, leaving a small garrison to keep an eye on the fort, returned to Seethawaka. While Tikiri Bandara had been besieging the Colombo Fort, Veerasundara Bandara and his son Konappu Bandara had been ruling Kandy in Tikiri Bandara's absence. However, when Tikiri Bandara suspected their complicity in a rebellion that had occurred whilst he had been besieging the Colombo Fort, he rushed to Kandy. He did not know whether or not his subordinates were guilty, but to be on the safe side, he had Veerasundara Bandara assassinated a short time later. Konappu Bandara, upon learning of his father's death, fled the Kingdom of Kandy, travelling to the Portuguese stronghold in Mana and placing himself under their protection. Thus, Tikiri Bandara was left the sole ruler of the kingdoms of Kotte, Seethawaka and Kandy, all unified under the Seethawakan banner. The Kingdom of Seethawaka now covered almost the entire island of Ceylon and had reached the peak of its power under the greatest of its rulers, the mighty Seethawaka Rajasinghe. all serious threats to Seethawakan dominance had been neutralized, and it seemed that Seethawaka would last for a long time yet. But as deadly to the stability of a kingdom as external threats are internal threats, and this kingdom of Seethawaka would fall a very short time later through internal instability. The tale of Seethawaka's decline will be covered in my next video. Don't forget to like, comment and subscribe for more content on Sri Lankan history. It helps immensely to keep the channel going. And as always, thank you for watching.